A warm welcome everyone. I am Dr. Dipankar Das, Consultant Cardiologist at Narayana Super Speciality Hospital, Guwahati. In today's session, we'll be discussing about what is heart attack, what are its causes, and how can we prevent heart attack. Nowadays, we often hear about young people who are dying due to heart attack. Now, young people as young as 30 to 40 years of age. Take for example the recent example of our BCCI president Mr. Sourav Ganguly, who has had a heart attack. So the incidences of heart attack is rising in India, and so are the deaths that are related to it. So let us understand what is the reason behind the incidences of heart attack in India, and what can we do so as to prevent such events to happen. Now, as we all know, heart is one of the most essential organ of the body. It functions continuously from childhood to death. It acts like a pump, pumping blood through all the different organs and parts of the body. And along with the blood, it carries all the nutrients, elements and nutrition to various parts of the body. And hence, it is one of the most essential parts of the body. The muscles of the heart continuously pumps and relaxes to pump the blood to all parts of the organ. The rate at which the heart pumps per minute is what is known as the heartbeat of the person. So on an average, the heartbeat for a normal person is what we know as the 72 beats per minute. In other words, the heart pumps and relaxes for 72 times in a minute. To do such an extensive work continuously non-stop from childhood to death, therefore, the heart also needs its own blood supply so as to have nutrients to its own muscle. So this network of blood vessels which supply the heart itself are known as the coronary arteries and the coronary venous system. Any impairment of blood flow in any of these coronary vessels will result in heart failure or heart attack. Heart attack occurs when blood supplies to the heart itself through the coronary arteries are blocked. Let's understand why there should be blockages in the blood vessels of the heart. So the main reason for blockages in the heart are mainly genetic and age. It is an age-related disease. The chances of having a blocked artery is more as we age more. So blockages can be because of age. It may be genetic, as there may be family histories of having a heart disease in mother, father, or brother or grandparents. Also, certain lifestyle like smoking or excessive alcohol consumption can also result in heart attack. Other than that, high blood pressure or diabetes or excessive cholesterol in the body can result in blockages in the heart. Now let us understand why there will be blockages of blood vessels. Main reason behind such incidences are increased blood pressure and excess of cholesterol and fat deposition in blood vessels. Persistent high blood pressure can damage the blood vessels by making them more rigid and by damaging their inner walls. Now, due to these blockages, heart of the patient with high blood pressure has to work harder to pump the blood throughout the body. This increases the workload of the heart and increases the oxygen demand of the heart. Any mismatch between the oxygen demand and its low supply because of blockage in the heart may ultimately lead to heart attack and ultimately heart failure. So a heart attack may cause multiple symptoms. Chest pain is one which is the most known symptom of a heart attack. It is a common symptom. It can feel like an uncomfortable pressure in the chest or an aching or numbness, or there may be radiation of the pain to the left arm. But it should be known that chest pain is not the only symptom of a heart attack, more so for a diabetic patient. A diabetic patient may have an atypical symptom also, for example, dizziness or fainting or lightheadedness. Heart attack may also present as nausea or indigestion or any gas problem. There may also be associated shortness of breath. These heart attack symptoms can be different for each person. No two heart attacks are the same, even for the same person. Persons may just have one or a combination of symptoms. Sometimes the symptoms of a heart attack are not the classic crushing chest pain that is well known. One may feel less obvious symptoms such as a burning feeling in the chest and shortness of breath. Sometimes one may have no warning sign symptoms at all. So a heart attack, as we all know, is a medical emergency. A heart attack can only be diagnosed by medical tests. The only way to know what you are experiencing is a heart attack or not is to seek an urgent help. Medical test includes an ECG. An ECG can provide information about the extent and the location of the muscle damage that is happening inside the heart. It also detects the heart rate and the rhythm of the heart. Next test that should be done is an echocardiography. It is known as the ultrasound of the heart. So it can be used to learn how the heart is pumping overall and what areas might not be pumping normally because of the blockage. The next test that should be done are the troponins and the CPK-MBs. These are the cardiac biomarkers or to know whether there is any damage inside the heart or not. Elevated troponins or elevated CPK-MB is an indication of heart attack. Once a doubt of heart attack has been made by ECG, echo and cardiac biomarkers, CPK-MB and troponin, then for 100% to be 100% sure whether the early heart attack has happened or not, we should be doing a coronary angiogram. Coronary angiogram is an invasive procedure and it requires the patient to be hospitalized. After hospitalization, through a local anesthesia from the hand, a catheter will be placed inside the heart, and within 5 to 10 minutes, we can be very sure whether there is any blockage in the heart or not. Any blockage in the heart at that point of time will mean that the patient has had a heart attack. Now, say a blockage has been detected in the heart and heart attack has been confirmed. So what to do next? Now, heart attack, as I told mostly, it is an emergency and requires emergency treatment to restore the blood flow to the heart. The faster this happens, the less the heart muscle is damaged, and hence the saying that time is muscle for heart attack. Heart attack treatments may involve either medication or opening of the blockages either by angioplasty or through a bypass surgery. Medications that are given are usually Ecosprin or Diplet or Ticagrelor. In other than that, we also give statins for cholesterol reduction. Medications for heart attack includes antiplatelet drugs like aspirin, anticoagulants, some beta blockers and statins for cholesterol reduction. Also, we have to monitor the blood pressure and keep a watch for chest pain. Ongoing chest pain is an indication that the muscle of the heart is continuously getting more damage. And so if chest pain is there, then urgent intervention is required. Now, heart attack can be prevented. Knowing your risk of coronary heart disease is the first step to reduce risk of having a heart attack. Yet many people don't know that they are at risk. The best way to find out the risk of having a heart attack is to get a regular health checkup and a heart checkup if we are above the age of 45 years of age, and even if we are at a lesser age but have a family history of heart disease, then we should get ourselves checked every 1 year. One can reduce their risk by making positive changes to their lifestyle, such as treating the blood cholesterol. Foods higher in cholesterol levels and saturated fats levels can contribute to high cholesterol and reduce the blood flow and increase the risk of a heart attack. Hence, it is very important to start a heart healthy diet and to reduce the risk. We should limit foods that are high in saturated fat, which comes from animal products such as ghee, butter, cheese, fatty meats and dairy desserts, tropical oils and also highly processed foods. We should choose unsaturated fats which don't raise cholesterol levels. One can find unsaturated fats in foods like nuts, fish, vegetable oil, olive oil and sunflower oils. A diet high in fiber can help lower the cholesterol levels by as much as 10%. This diet emphasizes increased intake of fresh fruits and vegetables, whole grains, poultry, fish and nuts, while curbing sugary foods and beverages. eating and drinking too much sugar can raise the triglyceride levels. A heart healthy eating plan can help manage the blood cholesterol level. So, controlling high blood pressure is of utmost importance. Drinking too much alcohol can raise the blood pressure. It also adds extra calories which may cause weight gain. Cigarette smoking also raises the blood pressure and puts us at a higher risk of having a heart attack and also stroke. So excess salt intake is also known to raise the BP. Reducing these factors can help to reduce further complications of it. So we should follow an exercise plan and maintain an ideal body weight. Regular physical activity makes the heart stronger. If one have a strong and healthy heart, it can pump more blood with less effort, reducing the risk of hypertension and heart failure. Exercise cuts bad cholesterol levels and raises the good cholesterol levels. One can aim to get 2 hours and 30 minutes of moderate aerobic activity per week, like brisk walking, or 1 hour and 15 minutes of high intensity exercise such as jogging per week. Monitoring stress levels and getting adequate sleep are also possibly the best ways to prevent heart problems. It is important to remember that we can afford everything, but nothing is as precious as the health. It is possible to make heart healthy and prevent heart failure or heart attack through lifestyle interventions like dietary modifications and exercise. By taking action to lower blood pressure, one can help protect themselves against the attack. Thank you.